Hey there, everybody. I recently gave a presentation at Retina Day, which is a meeting of several thousand retina specialists that occurs in conjunction with the annual meeting of the American Academy of Ophthalmology. And I know many of you weren't able to be at the meeting, so in this video I just want to share a few highlights from my talk, which was about an exciting project we've been working on at the University of Iowa, and in collaboration with Intel Corporation, to provide patients with a non-invasive wearable enhancement for advanced peripheral visual field loss. As you know, wearable electronic technology has become an exciting and active area of consumer electronics recently. Health and medical wearables are commonplace in today's world and include the Fitbit and other watch-like devices that monitor heart rate, steps, sleep cycles, and other physiologic functions. A similar wearable device for our visually impaired patients is the FDA-approved BRAINPORT, which uses a spectacle-mounted camera to modify a 400-electrode array that's placed on the user's tongue in order to simulate central vision. Other options for those with severe visual impairment include the Argus 2, which is an FDA-approved epiretinal implant, and the Iris 2 bionic vision system, which is an EU-approved subretinal implant, though these devices require surgical intervention and may be difficult to modify as technology improves in the future. Another limitation of these devices is that they are designed as substitutes for central vision. But what about individuals with retinitis pigmentosa, or advanced glaucoma, or other conditions that have resulted in the loss of their peripheral vision? These individuals, as seen here, must be constantly scanning their environment, and they often require sighted guides, or canes, to safely navigate their surroundings and to feel comfortable in social situations, as simple as meeting coworkers in a hallway, as you can see here. The man in this video is Daryl Adams. Daryl's a project manager at Intel who was diagnosed with retinitis pigmentosa about 30 years ago. At the 2015 Consumer Electronics Show, Daryl and Intel CEO Brian Krzanich demoed a wearable prototype which uses Intel RealSense 3D camera technology to simulate one's peripheral visual field by causing various boxes in the user's undergarment to vibrate as objects enter distinct areas of the camera's view, which may otherwise go undetected to someone with poor peripheral vision. In order to promote R&D of this device, Intel publicly released the software and the hardware specifications in early 2016, and since April of this year, we've been collaborating with Intel engineers to improve and to further develop this device. So how does this particular wearable technology work? Well, the device uses a depth sensing camera, a battery, and a computer to create a 3D image of the environment in a 40 degree vertical by 50 degree horizontal visual field and within a range of about 0.5 to 4 meters. An infrared laser beam is projected upon the environment, and then the stereoscopic array that's recorded by the right and left infrared cameras allows triangulation of the points and creation of a 3D image of the environment, much like our right and left eyes do naturally. This 3D image is then overlaid on a standard red, green, blue camera image, and the image is divided into 8 separate sections. The computer receives this image and then wirelessly transmits the signal of the whereabouts of various objects in 3D space to 8 small boxes, 6 of which are worn within the subject's undershirt and the remaining 2 on each ankle. Each of these boxes then vibrates with increasing intensity as objects within that section become closer to the user. This is a video of one of our engineering students walking in front of this device and simulates how a patient with poor peripheral vision may benefit from its use. The bright central circle represents the user's approximately 10 degrees of remaining visual field, and the red-blue colored map demonstrates how the various boxes vibrate as objects move within each section of the camera's view. This video here shows what it might be like to blindly navigate a large room with multiple obstacles using only this device. Remember that the changing colors seen on the right represent the variations in distance from each obstacle, which are then transmitted to each box in varying intensities as the object in that area of the visual field gets closer. So what is the status of this project? Well, we are currently working with Intel to improve the system architecture, the software, and the functionality of the device, and now have IRB approval to assess the performance and usefulness, with several subjects already enrolled in qualitative testing. Most recently, we have been working to improve comfort and functionality using the device, and have created a 3D printed attachment to the popular GoPro camera chest mount, and are also developing several quantitative tests of the device's distance and visual field capabilities. Just to wrap this up, we're optimistic that this device has the potential to become a wearable, non-invasive alternative for patients with advanced peripheral visual field loss. Thanks for watching, and please feel free to leave your comments or questions below.